Hello and welcome to WPLMS Tips. In this tip, we are going to learn how to translate BuddyPress strings into your custom language. So right now we are in the WordPress admin dashboard in the settings general section, and we have already enabled the site language option. So we are going to set a language. So as you can see, we have now changed the language and some of our texts have been translated into the Spanish language. Now if we reload our front end, while some of the strings have been translated, there are quite a few which are not. So most importantly, the strings such as activity, profile, notification, messages, friends, groups, forums, these strings are located in BuddyPress. So we need to ensure that we have the BuddyPress translation file in our WPLMS setup. So for this, we will download the Spanish translation file from BuddyPress. So we'll quickly do a Google search on BuddyPress translations. And in the BuddyPress page, we can see a link to the translate.wordpress.org. Now here we can see that we have translation files for following BuddyPress projects. So we're going to download the development one and locate our translation language, that is Spanish. So here we can see all the translations for the Spanish language, and we'll quickly go to export, and it will download a file called BuddyPress-dev. Now for translation, we are going to use the code styling localization plugin. So make sure you have installed the code styling localization plugin from the plugins add new section. Once you have installed it, you can locate a localization section under the tools in WordPress admin panel. So now we are going to locate plugins, and we are going to locate the BuddyPress, and we'll add a translation for the Spanish language. So now when we are adding the translation, it says that the following folder does not exist. So we need to create this folder bp-languages in the BuddyPress plugin. So once we have created this, if we try to add a new language for the BuddyPress translation, and we can see it has been added. So the code styling localization plugin adds the buddypress-es_es.po file for the BuddyPress, which we are going to replace by the translation file we just downloaded from the WordPress link, and then rename the one we downloaded from the internet. So now in the code styling localization plugin, we are going to rescan this, the BuddyPress package. So now that the BuddyPress package has been rescanned, we are now going to edit the language file and create a MO file. So once the MO file has been generated, if we now go to our front end and reload the page, you can see all our BuddyPress translations have been successfully translated. So that's it from WPLMS Tips. Thanks for watching.